In censorship, there is a chain of command. Or I should say, when it comes to online censorship, there is a chain that links us all and allows us to network throughout this chain. At any point in that chain, a link can be broken and you are censored. What I mean by this is, Twitter can absolutely say your free speech is your right and we're going to leave you up. But their data center, whoever provides the, you know, the transaction and storing of the data, could say, we don't want white supremacy on our servers, so we're going to get rid of all of Twitter unless you ban this person. Then Twitter bans that person. That way, they're gone. It could also be the financial transactions. The banking institutions could say to Twitter, we're not going to deal with you or your business because you promote hate speech. In which case, you're banned because no company is going to sacrifice itself for one person. It doesn't make sense. I have talked with some of, you know, I don't want to name anybody specifically, but there are some free speech networks. And I said, what if one person posts something and they threaten to take down the entire network because of that one person? They said, that's a really tough choice. Do we get rid of everything? You know, like, so right now I'm talking about Gab. Let's say Gab supports, you know, let's just do a round number, 100 people. If they provide more speech, more free speech to a wider range of people than Twitter does, is it beneficial then to make sure it maintains its service? And if one person threatens that service, wouldn't it be better to have 60 people who can speak, get rid of the one person, as opposed to what Twitter does and gets rid of the 60 people in favor of the 30, right? What I'm trying to say is, if Gab is a service that helps people speak about ideas that they can't on Twitter, and one person threatens that, should you get rid of that person? We have a story here that has to do with this chain. Gab tweeted out, Gab's hosting provider, Microsoft Azure, has given us 48 hours to take action on two posts, or they will pull our service and Gab will go down for weeks/months. And they posted these photos. It says, action required, Microsoft Azure acceptable use policy. This message is to notify you that the Microsoft Azure safeguards team received a complaint of malicious activity originating from your Azure deployments. Details of the complaints and results of our initial investigation are included below. Failure to respond to this complaint within 2 business days or continued violation of the Microsoft Azure acceptable use policy may result in the suspension of your deployments. You are responsible for addressing complaints from third parties regarding your use of Microsoft Azure, including any use by your end users. Microsoft Azure service terms and other agreement terms can be found at, and they link. They then have this. Please take the appropriate next steps to resolve this notice. Promptly take appropriate action and resolve the complaint. If you're surprised by this activity, yada, 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 we get it. And they have another photo and it says, complaint received. Abuse report regarding gab.ai. Phishing URLs. And then links to 2 posts on Gab. Evidence gathered. Both URLs are active. These are not phishing URLs, okay? A phishing URL is a link designed to trick you into giving up your personal details. It can take various forms. These links are to Gab posts. That's it. It's basically a tweet, right? It functions very similarly. So this is incorrect. It would seem that all Gab has to do is respond to Microsoft and say, hey, this is wrong. These are not phishing. These are direct links to a social media platform. However, it's possible that they're going to get banned unless the easiest thing they can do is get rid of them. Here's what's interesting. A lot of people right now are discussing that they're saying this is showing this problem of the chain in the internet and how a link can be broken at any point and you can get banned. That's true. That is true. But I want to point out in this instance, Gab probably should have taken down these posts. And that may surprise you, but I am not a free speech absolutist, right? And let me explain what that means. Free speech absolutism, which many people misunderstand because I think like Kyle Kalinske, who's on the left, said he was, means you believe in inciting violence. There are people who believe you have a right to stand up on a pedestal and say, go attack those people, right? You don't legally have that right. In this country, there's the yelling fire in a crowded theater. There is some speech that is disruptive and causes harm, and we have restrictions on that. But for the most part, reasoned arguments and certain things are fine. So let's take a look at exactly what happened. Gab said, Patrick Little has voluntarily removed the post cited by Microsoft. Now, I want to say this. There's probably a lot of people who are angry saying, Tim, how could you be against free speech? He has a right to say what he says. Just wait till I get to what he says and you'll understand what I'm saying. But first, I want to show you what he responded with. He said, I'll delete the posts, but this is a violation of our rights as Americans. Having to self-censor on Gab for this most likely means the vendors and service providers that Gab depends on will force ever more censorship. Me censoring these 2 posts solves no problem in the end. I may be in the wrong deleting these posts, but I am making a snap judgment call We will have no rights until... I'm not even going to read that. This is somebody on Gab who is very anti-Semitic, right? I don't know what you'd call them. I'm going to call him anti-Semite, and I'm not going to read what he put because I think it's absolutely ridiculous. And I want to say right now to everybody who holds those views or to anybody in general, anybody who tells me about like the JQ, I think of them as a social justice warrior because they're literally the same thing. You think there's some dominant racial group that has control over everything, that there's too many of them in certain positions of authority. And yeah, it's like the exact same argument. You really could interchange like white supremacy with like the JQ and the arguments are the same. I made a video about it after Charlottesville. You could replace the 1%. You could replace patriarchy. You could replace cis heteronormativity. And then everyone acts like those are the paramount problem. So I take issue with this kind of rhetoric. However, in this post, I agree he has a right to say that. I think it's absolutely silly, but by all means, be a social justice warrior. However, he said some other things that I don't agree with and don't defend, and I think Gab should have removed themselves. I don't know exactly what posts caused Gab to have to take some posts down or cause this man to remove these posts. I do know someone responded with, "You mean for this?" First, let's start with something that let's read it. He said, "No amount of suffering could repay eye for an eye." I'm not going to read it. I'm going to let you guys read it because I am not going to say this because I don't appreciate it. I really don't. But I do recognize to a certain extent the right to free speech. You know, he says disparaging things about Jewish people, introducing a plan to raise them as livestock, providing a steady supply of vessels for vengeance for the hundreds of years of crops that will have been raised for ritual death by torture. Like, this is horribly offensive, but I don't think anything said there is illegal, right? Let's look at the next one. You can be offended by that. I understand, but, you know, I don't know if that's removable. However, he posted on Gab, "I will see the..." He said, I'm not going to quote him because people are going to take me out of context. He said that he wants to see the destruction of U.S. Holocaust memorials in the next 12 months. And he says that he will personally do it himself. He said it was a campaign vow. He called it the Holohawks. And he said either it's revised or he will revise it. And then he said he was going to count down a stream to him actually taking up an illegal activity. This should be removed. Violence is defined as causing harm or destruction to someone or something. This is someone demanding violence and threatening violence, okay? And I don't believe that is protected. He is literally saying he's going to take a utensil and commit an act of violence. Now, the argument from the left is that objects have no rights and that you can't incite violence against a window and that breaking a window isn't violence. You're wrong. Breaking a window is violence. It is a physical act of destruction against someone or something. And that's the goddamn definition. Don't take my word for it. Violence is behavior involving physical force intended to hurt, damage, or kill someone or something. In this case, here is someone who said they were going to commit an illegal crime. Okay, vandalism is a crime. Destroying public property or state-supported property or federal property is a crime. And this person said they were going to do it. This is not the hill to die on. I would say that to Gab. I don't know if this is the post that needed to be removed. I do know they're not phishing URL, so that was, you know, false flag, it would seem. And I mean, like, falsely flagging. But what I can say is there's a lot of people right now who are acting like this is true censorship. Assuming this is the post, and I don't know if it is, I want to make that clear, this is not censorship. Getting rid of this is not censorship. This is actually a crime in the United States. To say that you are going to go and commit a crime is, like, to threaten violence against property, I'm pretty sure is a crime. I could be wrong. I looked up what criminal threats were, and the only few definitions I could find said that criminal threats were against a person. So I know that vandalism is a crime. I know that vandalism is violence. In this instance, I would say that he is absolutely threatening violence or inciting to violence, you know, saying that either the memorial is revised or he will revise it with a sledgehammer. That sounds like coercive threats against public property, against a memorial. I don't think Gab should allow that kind of speech. Look, I don't like Antifa going and smashing windows, and I certainly don't like people taking sledgehammers to Holocaust memorials. I actually really despise everything this guy is saying, but in terms of him, you know, being a right-wing SJW, I guess whatever you can call it, sure, that's fine, rag on Jewish people, but don't threaten to commit an act of violence or destruction. So let's look at a couple of the responses. Someone said, the tentacles of censorship have reached the hosting providers. It's possible now that domain name registrars and website hosts will make an attempt to create their digital utopia free of God, wisdom, and truth. Someone said they already did. And then we can see that they, you know, somebody came in and highlighted this. So let's look at this. This guy said, yes, Gab, racist speech, sexist speech, all sorts of ugly speech should be protected. What should not be permissible are thinly veiled opinions about how other people deserve to have violence done to them. Pretty simple. Yes. I don't know about the idea of like thinly veiled, but if you are inciting to violence, that's illegal. That's one of the stipulations we have in this country you're not allowed to do. Okay, so you can talk about everybody you hate all day and night, and that's fine, but the Supreme Court, you know, drew a line. And that's the, you know, look, I'm gonna go with where we're currently at in law and respect people to express their opinions. Someone said, I think his direct threat of property destruction is totally legitimate reason to delete his posts and ban him from the platform. It's disturbing that Gab does not seem to understand that. And someone said, if he's broken the law, report him to the cops. Don't put any onus on an internet platform to censor. Not hard to understand. I actually agree with that. In terms of taking someone down, banning the posts, you know, upon seeing that, let me just clarify, or I should say, this may have changed my opinion to a certain extent. There is the argument that social media companies should let people do whatever they want, and if they break the law and the police tell them to, then they take down that speech. So in terms of what Twitter, Facebook, and other platforms allow, threatening to commit an act of vandalism, in my opinion, is, you know, threatening to commit a crime, an act of violence, and maybe the best response is for the police to deal with it. So maybe it's the case. I will say, however, Microsoft Azure is probably not going to support someone threatening to commit a crime, you know, through their hosting providers, in which case I'm not surprised to see this. It is a problem that we have this chain, and you can be censored at any point, no matter what the intentions are of someone within that chain. Anyone at any point of that chain can take you out. That's concerning. It's concerning that these were labeled phishing posts, because it's not phishing with a PH. So, I don't know. Let me know what you think. Comment below and let me know what you think about this, because this was actually really interesting. I had a lot of people saying he's threatening property destruction. It's not a threat of violence against an individual. He should be allowed to say it. And I don't know if that's true. I think this is a really interesting bit of nuance here in the discussion. Should this person be allowed to threaten vandalism? Should it be left up to the police? Or, yeah, I guess that's about it. Should they be banned? You know? So let me know what you think. I don't know. I don't know exactly what I think at this point. I think it's really interesting. But suffice it to say, we're seeing the hosting provider problem of censorship happening. So anyway, I'm pretty wiped. I think that's about it for today. So stay tuned. I'll have more videos up on my main channel tomorrow at 4 p.m.